party. How's the internet going to be tonight? Welcome along, everyone. It's Friday. Here we are again. I hope you're doing well. Karen, how you going? Candace, how you doing? Dane, Brett, how you going, champ? Ali, Angela, how you going? Who else have we got? Vanessa, Phil, how you doing? Johnny Colligan, how you going, champ? Jason Howard, happy bloody birthday, champion. Happy birthday. Hope you've had a great day. Hope they spoil the crap out of you. Who else have we got? Oh, it's just caning. Nick. Liam, how you going, buddy? Harrison, how are you, champ? Dez, Claire, Brett, Amy, Tim. I've got Fran, the other Tim, and Tony. How you going, champ? Check out Tony's new song, by the way. He's got a video up. If you go to his page, you should be able to find it. And they released their own song the other day, him and another guy, so you should go and check that out. Maddie, how you going, champion? Tony, how you going? Melissa, hello. Luke, how are you, champ? Hope you're well. All right, I'm just going to let the room fill up a little bit more, and got a big show tonight. They all seem to be pretty big at the moment. It's fucking cool. But Charles, how are you, man? Brad, how are you, buddy? Hope you're well. And yeah, it's just, we've got heaps coming up tonight. So we've got, we're going to be chatting to Scotty Target a bit later from Roboticus. Awesome friend of mine from down Hobart in his original act, and they've just dropped a new track today. So we'll be having a chat to him. Don't forget the chief. Fiona, how you going? Who else have I got? Aaron, how are you, buddy? Hope you're well. Anne-Marie, how you doing? Michael Westcott, how are you, champ? All right. Yes, so we will be chatting to Scotty Target a little bit later. We're going to have some performances again this week. Tori is back on the guitar and singing again, so we'll be hearing from her. We'll also be hearing from Jack McNiff and Dane Leonard. We'll be doing a track. The Corona House Band are back again. Just we had a horror week of things just not going out the way we wanted, which was my computer being very uncooperative. Jade got sick. We've just had a fun week trying to get to this week's track together. So hopefully it'll look like none of that happened. Who else we got? Brooke, how you going? Hope you're well. Brooke's going to be joining me in a song a little bit later as well, which will be awesome. Who else have we got? Brett College. He's going to put in a little performance for you as well. All right, I'm going to start with a little track just to start with. I don't know this one very well, but it's a cool song, so I'm just going to do it. Got a sync problem, have we? Sync problem. I haven't done anything different. Let's hope. I know I can change some stuff. I believe. Maybe. settings are in here. So I do apologise if we're having some sync troubles. I've never come across that before with the settings that I've currently got. No, that one goes like this. Jace is about, can you remind me via text where that sync setting was? I might give that a try. I can't find it. Oh, damn it. Just when you think everything's going to go to plan, we've had the shittiest week trying to get stuff ready for this show, and now we've got sync issues. Sync's fine now. Hopefully it's just caught up and we don't have to stress. Anyway. Let's just go with it. I'm going to play a song and we'll just see what happens. Try and play a song. Listen to the sound of revolution. Everybody's not on the street tonight. Everybody's cool. Everything's alright. Better pray your old man don't go and get on tonight. If we drive my car, we'll wipe things off. We got a green limousine. Everyone's a star, but they won't get far without a burn the flag of your convention. Set the wheels in motion here tonight. Everybody's cool. Everything's alright. Everybody want your own. You're gonna get it on tonight. When the wild things all got a green limousine. Everyone's a star, but they won't get far without a green limousine. Green limousine. Green Everybody's cool. Everything's alright. Got this feeling in my bones. We're gonna get it on tonight. If you drive my car with the wide fans up, we got a green limousine. Every man's a star on a shooting star. We got a green limousine. My tech. Jace, how's the sync going now, guys? Are we still out? Well, it takes a little bit before you answer, so I'll just check first before I change anything. Just double check that there is... Let Let's see. How we going? Still out. Bugger. Bugger, 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 bugger. Let's try. Start about 1500, Jay says. Let's try that and see what happens. How is that? I might have to do a redial, which I don't really want to do. I'm not sure if I can come back to the same stream. Clap my hands. All right, clap my hands. We'll do a sync test. And then I have to wait because there's a delay before it gets to you guys. So we'll see how we go. I apologize for the sync delay. It's a pain. Worse now. Okay, that's even worse. So let's try. Let's try something. So we're going into negatives now. This is negative 200 milliseconds. Sounds like a typical punter clapping on. How's that? See what that does. Oh, the joys of going live, hey? Closer, but still out. Okay, we'll go up even further. We'll try 500. Apologize. We will get there. How's this one? We might get lucky. It might just all of a sudden just work. Apologize, because there's going to be a bit of dead air when I get an answer, and then from when I say something. So I'll try again. Closer again. Okay, we're going good. Let's try. We'll try 1,000. Negative 1,000. No, it doesn't want me to do that. Missed it by that much. I know. Oh, no one wants to see that happen. That'll just break the internet will shut down completely, Heath. I'll get nipple banned as quick as you can poke a stick. I know, it's insane, isn't it, Matt? Of all the things that could happen. After the week that we've had. That's pretty close. Okay. I think that's about as far as I can push it. I might be able to go that far. No, it doesn't work. Doesn't work. Bad. All right. I apologize for that little hiccup there. Hopefully that's okay. So I'll do one more test. just check. Go with that. If not, I got no idea, and you're gonna have to. It's either that or I have to start 30 seconds. Really? Everyone else reckon it was okay. Yep. Okay. Pain in the bloody bum. That's what it is. I've never had that happen before. Anyway, we're going to go with it. Sorry if it is out for anyone. If not, bad luck. All right. So this week we have a new sponsor on board. I'm going to snick that one in now because he's been chatting there, which is Dave from DK Audio. I've done a bunch of work with Dave. And it's an absolute lead. 60 minutes out now. Piss off, Jason. I know it's your birthday. I've done a bunch of stuff, work with Dave, and he's an absolute professional and an absolute legend. Hope you're going well, mate. You know, he's like most of us, all stuck with no work at the moment, and which is a bugger. He has jumped on board and sponsored this week's show, which is really, really cool of him. So thanks, buddy. And we also have Karen back again from Paragon Bookkeeping and Accounting. I think I got that right. Or accounting and bookkeeping. One of the two. She does both. She does all the stuff. So if you need any advice on any of the, you know, the minefield that is all this JobKeeper and all this crap that's going on at the moment, which has just been an absolute pain in the bum, Karen will just sort you all out, knows everything, how to do it all, and will keep you on top of it. Even if you just need some bookkeeping and stuff done. Anyway. Check them out. So hopefully we're not too bad. I'm going to just stop listening to all you guys because I don't know if I'm in sync or not. Anyway, first thing, right, I'm going to just reset. I'm going to throw to our first performer, which is Tori. Tori sent through another track. She also wanted me to dedicate this song to Aaron Worker, who's a good mate of hers. And she said she'd like to dedicate this song to him. So, Aaron, this one's for you, champion. Here we go. Hopefully this is in sync, because if this is in sync, we've got serious problems, because it's a bloody video.
Hey, guys. Coming at you again from my lounge room. Same warnings apply as my last video, featuring on Lee's live cast every Friday night. The budgie will make noises. But anyways, before I'm going to play a song, I wanted to just tell you about this little guitar that I'm playing right now. It's a guitar that the very first guitar that my pop gave me. He got it for a carton of beer, I'm pretty sure, at a pub one time when he was playing, because 90% of my vocal or music talent comes from my mum's side of the family. Sorry, Dad. We still all love every song that you sing in the shower and did for my entirety of growing. But anyways, it's so old that, I don't know, a few of you probably would remember Nathan Wilden and the Two Timers. It's a pretty happy sticker, plus some Simpsons ones, because, I mean, that's just gold. Anyways, I'm going to play a song by Boy and Bear called Blood to Gold. Didn't even mean to do that weird segue, but... it's a song that I've also been playing for quite some time, but I just love the dynamics in it, and it always comes across really well when I've played it out live, so I hope that you guys enjoy it, and also enjoy it on a really old guitar with some pretty manky strings, but we'll see what they can belt out. One, two, three, four. mother told me, don't shoot run away, 'cause it takes a man to keep them hungry, but I'm so damn cold, and if this blood don't beat so cold, I think I'm staying safe and keeping in touch with your loved ones and just doing the absolute best that you can with a really shitty situation. All the love from me and my budgie Kevin and just all my lovers and all my good peoples, sending the good vibes out to you. Peace.
Alrighty, I have a special guest in the studio. Here she is, Santa, everybody. You have to talk into the microphone. You want to say g'day?
Hi.
Do you know what? Did you come out in the dark, did you? You've got your trusty little light going on. Yeah?
I think it's Jackson's. Then Mum used it, and then she left it out, so I used it.
Yep. So do you know it's Jason's birthday today? Did you know that?
Yeah, you told me.
I know. Do you want to wish him a happy birthday? Yeah. You have to look at that. That's where everyone is, at the camera there. And come over here. Mm-hmm. You're gonna sing happy birthday with me?
Ah. Ooh. Yeah.
All right. Let's see if I can. Ready?
Yeah.
Let's just move that because I can't. Give me that for a sec. Here we go. Santa's debut singing over it.
Happy birthday to you, happy birthday to you, happy birthday dear Pooh Bum. Happy birthday to
you.
Ready? Go. You can do the last drum. Hip hip.
Hooray.
Hooray. Hip hip.
Hooray.
Hip hip.
Hooray.
Happy birthday, Jace.
How old is he? How old do you think Jason is?
How old's Jason?
I don't know.
What do you reckon? Have a guess.
I don't know.
Come on, guess.
I don't know.
Like super old. He's older than Nan.
I don't even know how old Nan is.
No, he's not older than Nan. He's older than me, though.
I still don't know.
So, anyway, happy birthday, Jace. Hope you like that one. That was very impromptu. He said, here you go, over here, he said, beautiful, thank you, Senna. And he's put three hearts next to it. 84. And Jace said he's 22. Do you believe that?
No.
Brooke's 20.
I don't believe that.
He don't believe it. Dave said he's 5. How old are you now?
7.
7. That's like 2 hands now. Yeah. Jason's just said he's 69.
Jason.
Ange's gonna. Are you gonna come here and say good day to everyone? No, no. Ange is hiding behind the camera.
Yeah.
She doesn't want to get on camera yet. She's saving it. We have we're gonna have a big party in a couple of weeks. We've decided. We're going to have so just a bit of a heads up for everyone out there. We're going to have a night where we're going to play all the videos that everyone sent into us. We're going to play them all like a big, be like Rage. Have you ever seen Rage?
No.
It's on like real late at night, probably when you're asleep. And they have all sorts of different music on. And they have a host. And the host goes, this next song's blah, 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 blah. So we're going to do that. We're going to have our own little Rage with all Tassie musos. How cool's that?
Yeah.
Pretty cool.
Yeah.
All right. Thanks for singing. You helped.
Yeah.
Help me sing. Yeah? You're going to learn how to play an instrument?
Maybe.
What are you going to learn?
I don't know.
I reckon you should learn the drums. I reckon Dane reckons you should learn the drums. We'll start a band. Cool. I reckon we should play another track. What do you think? Should we play another song?
Maybe.
Have you been dancing in the lounge room?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Mm-hmm. It is a little bit hard to dance with these slippers on, though.
You got new slippers, have you?
Yeah.
They're good?
Yeah, but they actually get quite hot, but...
Yeah.
It doesn't really matter to me.
All right. So, look, we've got Santa as a guest host. We've got... You should play the recorder. Thanks, Tony. And then Karen said you should play the bagpipes.
I don't even know what one are.
Bagpipes. And they put them under, they go...
I still don't know that. I just didn't.
Go. Whatever that is. Scottish stuff. They wear kilts. Cool, all right. We should play a song, though. Who should we play? Let's have a look. Oh, I don't want to hit you. It's tight in here, isn't it? There's not a lot of room.
There's chords there, and there.
All right.
And there.
I'm gonna hand you over to me. I've done a song.
Yeah.
Yeah. I did a song. I did a video of a song this week. Yeah.
Yeah.
I've always wanted to. I've played this song before, and I normally play this song acoustically, and I've always wanted to do it as like a whole band. But it's a slow song, so I don't get a chance to do slow songs. I have to play happy dance songs normally. Yeah. So I'm going to put this song on now. I hope you like it. I'm going to dedicate this one to Cindy, if she's about, because she is the biggest fan of this band that I know in existence, other than myself. So I'm going to hand you over to a bunch of me's again. All right, here we go. You ready?
Oh, yes.
Do you want to introduce me? Do you want to say, hey, everyone, this is my dad? Nah, you don't want to introduce me. You're just like, nah, stuff you. All right, do you want to wave goodbye to everyone?
Bye.
Bye, everyone. All right, enjoy.
In my
Lies the snake in the sun in my
Alrighty. So, Santa's left the building. And, yeah, hope you enjoyed that. You know, I've been trying to sort of put something together myself every time. Every time we do one of these now, I'm sort of trying to do one as well myself and get everyone sort of, you know, doing stuff for me as well. So just huge thank you to everyone else that chips in and, you know, puts these videos together. It's not something that happens quickly, that's for sure. There's a lot of time and effort involved in putting a video like that together. So thanks, everyone. Jack, we 100% should do that, I think, next week. You and me, and we'll get Dane involved as well on that as well. I think that'd be cool. Big shout out to everyone that sent me through videos. I've got so many now. They keep coming. And huge thank you. Tonight's got a little bit of a Chris Cornell theme going on, so we've got another one coming up for you a bit later on, which you should definitely stick around for because it's awesome. All right. So just to sort of go back over everything, obviously the whole point of this little show was to raise some money for musos that are being affected and have been hit pretty tough by the shutdowns at the moment. And I know everything's sort of still a bit up in the air for us. We'll probably be the last people to actually sort of go back to work because obviously the restrictions are going to slowly, you know, hopefully lift as... You know, we've been sort of told today that there's a plan in place over the next few months, but I do believe that our work's probably going to be one of the last ones to go back online because our stuff revolves around having crowds. I do know a few of my friends are still really struggling. A couple haven't been able to get JobKeeper or JobSeeker, been just completely left out of the loop there for different reasons. So what we're obviously here for is to try and raise some funds to give directly to those people and just lighten the load and make it a little bit easier to get by over the next few months. So that's been the aim. So far, we have literally, you know, just been in touch with so many people and we still are. I still am. Like every day I'm talking to people and getting funds to those people. We've raised... I think last time I checked now, we're over 12 grand, which is insane, and it's still going. So, like I said, most of that money obviously goes straight back out the door as soon as we can, straight to other people. So we've literally helped, I reckon, close to like 35, 40 people in total so far, and that's still going. So it's the impact, this little stream that sort of started as just... you know, something to do, has just been massive. You know, my sort of big thing with the whole thing is I'm copying a lot of the thanks for it because obviously I'm the one running the stream and so forth. And I just sort of like, I get it. I get that, you know, I'm sort of in the position to be able to do it, but, you know, it's a big collaborative effort. There's a lot of people that have been involved in helping me do this. I definitely haven't done this just all by myself. When people thank me, I'm sort of like, there's no thanks needed. You know, at the end of the day, we're doing this because we are in a community and we're a music community and we help each other out when shit gets tough for us. And that's just what we do. So, my huge thanks to Peter. There's so many people that have helped me get this up and running and continue to keep it up and running every week. I've got, you know, from people like Jason Howard who helps me with tech stuff and has streamed from his house and, you know, goes, records, you know, Jade and Dane and stuff and gets all this stuff ready to Damon Wise, who's given us equipment. He's given Jason equipment so that they can record and stream from their house, just straight off his own back, through to our sponsors, people like Karen, people like Dave, that have sponsored the show for either a one-off show or they've sponsored it for weeks. Those people have given us the ability to be able to really sort of bolster the amount of money that we've earned, right through to all the musicians that are donating their time doing videos and recording each week. The Corona Band's a classic example. There's, you know, five people just, every single week, you know, sitting down, recording parts, recording videos, getting everything to me. Jade's done hers this week while she was crook, you know, like just stuff like that. So it's just, I just want people to realise that it's not just me, and that we're all sort of in this together and we've all been helping out. So I just want everyone to know that I appreciate all of you. So thanks very much for your help, and it's been heaps of fun putting all this stuff together and doing what we do. So anyway, enough waffling on. If you'd like to donate, the donate thing's down the bottom there. It's paypal.me/TazEntBookings, and that will take you straight to our PayPal account. If you click on, there's a button just underneath where you make your payment that says gift or goods and services or something like that. If you click that button, that check button off and get rid of it, we get the whole amount, and PayPal don't take their fees because it's not, they're charging you for goods, not for gifts. So if it is a donation, you click that button and we get all the money and there's no fees. Anyway, I'm going to shut up and sing a song. There you go, Heidi. So this song, I haven't done this song for ages, but I always liked it. It's cool. Shows.
She turned away. What was she looking at? A sour girl the day that you met me. Hey, what are you looking at? You was happy on the day that you left me. She turned away, what was she looking at? She was sour girl the day that you met me. Hey, what are you looking at? Was happy when she left me. What would you do? What would you do if I follow you? What would you do if I so happy on the day that he met her? Say, what are you looking at? I was Superman, but looked so deceiving. The roller coaster rides a lonely one. I pay the ransom, no, to stop it from steaming. Hey, what are you looking at? She was a teenager when she met me. What would you do? What would you do if I follow you? What would you do if I I follow.
bit of Stone Temple Pilots. Cool. Thanks, Brett. And yes, Jack, let's get on to that. I think we should definitely do that. We'll be sick. All right, so still got heaps coming up at in about five or so minutes, about 10 minutes. Scotty Target's going to jump on the line, and we're going to have a bit of a chat to Scott. And we're going to have a chat about his act Roboticus. They got a new single dropping today. It's really good. I've heard it. It's awesome. Sounds really, really, really polished. And it's local guy. He's from down in Hobart. And we'll get him on and have a chat. Very good friend of mine and a very, very good musician. Also, we will hear from, who else have we got on the line? We have Jack and Dane. Going to be doing a song. We've also got Brooke making appearance. The Corona Band's coming back tonight as well. And our friend and Brett College, who you may remember from the little video that Brett and I put together not that long ago. He is back on his ownsome to dazzle you once again with his an insane musical skill. All right, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to play the next track, which is from that Jack McNiff and Dane Leonard have sent through. So for those of you that don't know, obviously my band Super Mega, which is this subliminal message that I've been sending you guys now for the past 8 weeks. We've done this for 8 weeks. Can you believe that it's been 2 months that we've been doing this for? But Dane obviously plays drums in my band, Super Mega, and Jack is the singer. And in this particular track, Dane's playing guitar and bass, Jack's playing drums and singing. So I'm going to hand you over to them. This is, like I said, very much a Chris Cornell-inspired evening, so I hope you enjoy this song. I very much did. So here we go.
From
Alrighty, Jack McNiff and Dane Leonard, everybody. Just give me 2 secs. I get a chance every time I put a video on, I get a chance to put my heater on. It's bloody cold out here. And then I have to turn it off because it's really noisy. But how bloody good was that? For a drummer, you're not a bad guitarist, Dane. But nah, very, very cool. Just so you're aware, at the end of all of these episodes, I normally upload all the videos that I make to my YouTube channel, and I also upload the actual episode to my YouTube channel as well. So if you want to check out my YouTube channel is just my name. It's just Lee Ratcliffe. If you go there, subscribe, you know, all that wanky stuff that they tell you to do, and slap this and hit the bell and jiggle this and I don't know. You know, it's all the stuff that you're meant to do. But yes, we're waiting. We're in that, Kathy, we are in the process of getting that to happen. So I'm hoping we can make that happen this week. Needed more synth. Cool. So for those that would, you know, want to check out my YouTube channel, please do. I put everything up there afterwards. Sometimes it's a little bit easier than going back through the Facebook video and trying to find the thing that you want to listen to. So they'll definitely be up there. And you can check that out. Cool. So we've had a few donations roll through. So thank you very much to the people that have donated. It's absolutely awesome. I think it's about time that I get Scott on the line and have a chat to him because he's waiting in the wings. So I will get Scott online. I've just got to get my headphones ready. I have absolutely no idea how the sync's going to be for Scott. Let's see what happens. See what happens. All right. So, time for our my favourite song of the evening. Here it comes. I know this one better than all the others. Yo. There we go.
Hey, Ready.
How are you, man?
Very good. How are you? All
right, you get the lovely, lovely view of looking at the back of my head while I stand here and show everyone my lovely face. I don't know what's worse. Maybe I should show everyone else the back of my head instead of my guests.
Look, I'm happy to look at the back of your head if that's what works.
So tell me, what's been happening? You've been busy, I've heard.
Yeah, mate. Pumping away, like, kind of, lots of the gigs, just, business as usual, really.
Yeah.
Which is, you know, that's different for everybody, I guess.
Yeah. It's definitely,
but yeah, trying to get the tunes rolling and get new stuff happening.
It's definitely strange times, yeah. Isn't it? Definitely strange times. So you've got this project. So let's just give you a little bit of backstory on Scott. Scott's probably one of the most, probably the most underrated musicians that I know of in Tassie. He's done so much, and he's never one to talk himself up. So I'll talk him up for you. But Scott's had in the past. Scott's been in. He was in a band called the Dukes of Windsor. They had a number one song in Australia for God knows how long. It seemed like it was forever. How long was your track at number one for?
Oh, that's a good question. It was for quite a few months.
Yeah. It was.
Like most of the year or something like that in the club charts and.
Yeah. I can still remember one of my friends who didn't realise it was you guys, saying to me because he was working in a club at the time. And he's like, oh, I heard this song the other day. You should hear it. And he played me this song. I'm like, that's Scotty Target. And he's like, no way. But yeah, so basically, Scott Spandrick's Windsor is one of the bands that he was involved with. He's done a bunch of stuff. He's been on the Arias. He's been, you got best dressed at the Arias, didn't you? Didn't they? there's
yeah, there was something like that
for you.
Yeah, popped up in a magazine somewhere. It's like, hey, here we go,
Mr. Fashion.
Who would have thought?
He's
they must have been desperate that year, I reckon.
He's also performed for other acts as well. He was a member of Big Wally, another band. They were on like Recovery and stuff like that as well. So Scott's absolutely no stranger to the music scene. He's a very, very talented muso, and his new act is called Roboticus. If you have a look in the description of the feed, I've left a link to their Facebook page you can check out. So what's the new song called, mate? It dropped today, didn't it?
It did. Yeah. It's called Rinse, Repeat, out today.
Yep.
It's a song that I wrote with a local singer here called Anna Williams. Yep. We've been writing a bit of stuff together. And, yeah, this is the most recent one to finish off.
Now, so... And, so, just so everyone's aware, and Anna's not a member of Roboticus as such. She's a guest singer. So Roboticus is just you.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah.
And you you get other singers in, correct?
I'm gonna release other stuff as well and collaborate with different singers, and with this particular track, it was a collaboration with Anna. So
awesome.
That's right.
Yeah. Cool. So. I have heard you've done a film clip for this track, which is available. Whereabouts can we find the film clip?
Yeah, so before this whole lockdown situation happened, we did a little video for Tiny Blue Sessions, which is like a YouTube channel. You can look at that up. They've got some cool videos. It's all shot in a tiny house, which is really cool. Yep. All one shot. So Tom... the director there shoots it all in one clean swoop. You know, you sort of just perform the song and away you go.
Awesome.
So yeah, you can look that up. There's a bit of a clip for that.
Sorry. Actually get you to do is I might get you to just after you jump off, just if you want to throw a link up in the conversation to where they can see that film clip. Obviously, I've got your Facebook page up in the description, but yeah, if you want to put a link straight to that film clip, I'll get you to do that after you jump off.
I'll put it on there for sure.
Awesome. So, sure. What's next for Roboticus? What are you planning on doing? Like, well, obviously, we've got this song. What you know, was there any sort of touring or anything like that planned prior to, you know, being told that you had to stay at home and sit and watch Netflix for months?
There wasn't any touring as such lined up for Roboticus. A couple of local gigs.
Yep.
Just with some support stuff. But no, I was kind of knuckling down in the studio, really, which, you know, for this act, it was, you know, I guess good timing if that's the thing in this situation.
Yeah, yeah.
So, yeah, I've been trying to collaborate with more and more local musicians.
It's actually an interesting...
finishing off another track with Anna as well, and an extra track as well with a local girl, Crystal Sky, which is like a really soulful, kind of soulful disco number. You know, it's got the strings and all those disco parts.
Awesome.
Also working on, actually, Corey Gillum plays a little role in that song. So,
Coz?
Got Coz to lay down some bass.
We can't tag Coz in anything,
so
because Coz doesn't like Facebook.
He doesn't.
No. 9 times out of 10, Coz, you can't even reach Coz by
actually
the phone.
You have to pick up your phone and call Coz.
Nine times out of ten, you can't even get hold of him on the phone because his phone's being disconnected. Classic Coz. But
it's total old school. You got to go and knock on his door then.
Which we're not allowed to do.
We're not. What am I saying? We can't even do that.
It was actually an interesting point you brought up before about sort of getting the creative juices because you've got a bit of time. I've been having this conversation with quite a few people. Like, some people are actually taking to this time in isolation really, really well and being able to just, you know, go for it get in and do stuff. Even with what I'm sort of doing. But I have been speaking to a lot of people that have just been sort of hit really, really hard with their mental health and just haven't even wanted to touch an instrument, which is a bit of a shame on the other side of it. I've had that conversation with quite a few musos now that are sort of maybe a bit more extroverted than I am. I'm more of an introvert. I quite like being in my studio, in my own spot. But there are quite a few.
In your happy place.
Yeah, there are quite a few people out there that have really, really struggled with that part of it. So, interesting that you brought that up. So, anyway, moving forward, where can we find this new track of yours?
Well, you'll get it on Spotify, you'll get it on iTunes, you'll get it pretty much anywhere that you find your tunes in 2020.
Awesome.
Except for the CD shop, which I'm not sure if that's an essential service anyway, is it? It's search online anywhere, Roboticus, Rinse Repeat is the song.
Yep.
Out today.
And
it's great fun to make, actually. It was we created the song like probably 3 or 4 months ago, like with the beginning of the track, and it actually, you know, speaking of what you said before about happily sitting in your studio being antisocial, pretty much, that's kind of how we put the song together. Like, Anna sent me an MP3 of an idea that she had, the lyrics and melody. So I kind of responded to that and wrote this music part, sent it back to her and did that sort of a couple of times, and then we actually got together in the same room, which is I find it a great way to write, because it's, you know, you might have an idea, you can throw it in your phone just as a voice memo, send it to the other person, send it to the whole band or whatever situation you're in. Everyone's got it immediately.
Yeah.
You can work on it on your own. And when you get together, you've got these other ideas that you've had, and it's good. It's just another tool.
Yeah, yeah.
So
I have.
Yeah, you know, the isolation thing doesn't stop things.
No, it doesn't. And this sort of proves that, just the amount of collaboration that's been going on just with what I've been doing. It's just, you know, it's I was saying to you earlier on today, it's almost like, it's almost given me like full time job in trying, like, all the stuff that's been going on, all the music that's been going on, and I've practiced more in the last 2 months than I've practiced in the last 2 years. So hopefully I'm going to come out of this a much, much better player than what I was when I went back into it. I don't know. I'm still a sucker for a good mistake.
May I say, those videos, Raddy, are really cool.
Thanks, man.
They come off really well.
They're good fun.
And also, like, I caught the Black Hole Sun just a little while ago. Top marks.
Thanks, buddy.
Super cool.
Yeah, I've always...
I recall...
always wanted to do it.
Many times listening to that album with you back in the day.
Back in college.
Back in college, yeah.
I don't recall much of it at all, but hey.
Hey, it was a long time ago.
We are getting old, aren't we? We are getting old. So how's the family? How's everyone going at home? How are the kids? How's the wife?
Yeah, they're good. We're doing the homeschooling thing, which is, you know, as you know, it's quite a challenge.
It's definitely a challenge, so, isn't it? Like, I'm having to learn maths all over again. when you realize that you don't know the maths of a 7-year-old, you just, going, oh my God, what has happened? No.
So we only have to count to 4, don't we, as a musician?
Well, it depends. If you want to be a jazz muso, you've got to be able to count to 5.
Yeah, you're right.
One extra mile. But yeah, if you want to do pop, we're good. 4's it. All right, man. Well, I just huge thanks for taking the time out of your day to jump on and have a chat. And
pleasure.
And I really encourage everyone to go and check out Scott's project and his new song. I had a listen today, and it is absolutely magic. It sounds very, very slick. Who's the guy that you are doing this with? Because I think people might even know him. I didn't put the dots together until you told me today. What's the guy's name again that you have been working
with? Yeah, so Cal Young mixed this one.
Who is based...
we've been working together.
Is he a Tasmanian, or is he just... has he moved here?
Yeah, he lives here in Hobart.
Yep.
And he used to be... some of you might know him from his band, The Scientists of Modern Music, from a little while back. They had a bit of success and did a bit of touring, and that's where I came in contact with Cal. He was doing a tour with my band, The Dukes of Windsor, and that tour actually ended up quite a disaster, not from anyone in any band's fault, but... dodgy promoter, but that's another story.
there's always
from
one.
That, like, we got on very well, and we have lots of similar influences and like the same kind of music. So when I came back to live in Hobart, we started working together a fair bit. So I kind of go and play some keys on some of his tracks, and he does stuff on my songs. And so for my last few releases, we've sort of been working closely together. Awesome. And you know, I'll get my songs to a point, and then I'll go and do some sessions with him, and
he's changed. So he was in The Scientists of Modern Music, he's going under a different name now, yeah?
Yeah, so he goes by the name of Cal, so it's K-O-W-L.
Yeah, so check him out as
well. Play on words from his name, Cal. Yep. So you can look that up. That's, he's on Facebook and Instagram, and you find his stuff
awesome.
On Spotify or wherever you want to find
awesome.
It. But he's really great producer and really enthusiastic and loves his disco.
Yeah.
And he's just a passionate guy doing some really cool stuff.
Yeah, very, very cool. All right. Well, once again, thanks very much for coming on and joining me and having a chat. Everyone, the link's up in the description of the stream to Scotty's Facebook page, which is Roboticus. You can check out his stuff there. He's going to jump on afterwards and leave a link to the video for their latest track, which is called Rinse Repeat. You should definitely check it out. It sounds absolutely awesome. If you're into sort of disco-y dance, it's just very pop, very, very polished. It sounds great. And it's awesome to hear an old mate still smashing out tracks. It's great.
Thanks, Raddy.
All right, man.
Love your work.
Thanks, buddy.
Keep it up.
I will do. Don't you worry. And we'll catch up soon. Say good day to the family.
Likewise. Yep. Stay safe.
All right, man. Take it easy.
Yo.
Thanks, man.
Thank you. Cheers.
Cool, cool, cool. Scotty Target, everyone. I highly recommend you go and check out his stuff, because he is an absolute gun. He's a great keyboard player, a great songwriter, and all round just a generally a really, really nice guy. And I keep saying all along, we are so bloody spoilt for talent in Tasmania. It's just not funny. Like, there are so many hidden gems down in Tassie. We've got Grammy Award nominated bloody sound engineers. We've got, you know, people that have written number one songs. We've got some of the world's best artists. We just really, really have an insane amount of talent. And I just think, you know, look locally before you go looking elsewhere and just jump on the bandwagon of, you know, watching what's on your television and seeing the commercialised crap, that you just have a closer look to home, because we really do have some insane talent down here. Anyway, just a quick shout-out again to our sponsors this week. DK, Dave Kirkwood, the legend. He is an absolute legend. He's one of the nicest guys in the industry. We have some great guys in this industry, and he is one of them. And I've done a bunch of work with Dave. We've even recently we actually were working on a festival together, and lo and behold, that festival got canned because of this whole situation. So apart from the fact that he's been hit pretty tough, just like the rest of it, like the rest of us. He has still decided to jump on and sponsor a show, which is absolutely awesome. So thanks, buddy, for jumping on and sponsoring. Check out DK Audio. If you need any audio, he's the man. And also to Karen from Paragon Accounting and Bookkeeping. She has been with us from pretty much day dot and continues to keep us all sorted. So if you need any book work done, bookkeeping, stuff like that, she is an absolute legend and knows her stuff backwards. Also, Timmy Gambles is her son. So she's got good genes because she's got some serious talent going on that she's passed down there. And she knows music, the music scene. So if you're a muso and you need an accountant, get on to Karen because she's all across, you know, what we have to do as musos. All right, so I'm going to waffle out another song and then I'm going to put another video on. So I'm going to start first with this one and we'll go from there. Might try tuning, which I swore I just did. It just decided it did. My week has just been so bloody good. And there you go, Scotty has just posted the link there to the video. So after the stream, jump on, check that out. It's great.
I lost
So, we are 10:30. It's just, tonight's episode is just flown, and I think it might be because of all the sync stuff that I had going on to start with, which was just horrible. Anyway, hopefully that's all sorted and we're better and everything sort of makes sense and I don't look like a bad overdubbed film. So, just to recap, we are raising some money for Musos. If you would like to donate, even if it's, you know, $1 or $2 or $5 or $500, it doesn't really matter how much. I'm not fussed. But if you would like to donate, paypal.me/tasentbookings, we are giving that money directly to musicians. So musicians that have been hit pretty hard and haven't been able to get any funds in the sort of short term. We have had a few people contacting me that haven't even been able to get Job Seeker, Job Keeper, or whatever, for whatever reasons they've been knocked back. I know a lot of people didn't get any of the grants that came through as well. So, the promised money doesn't always end up in the pockets of the people that really, really need it. But anyway, that's just how it crumbles sometimes. But we are getting contacted by people that are in that situation. So the aim is to help those people out for as long as we can until such time as we run out of funds. So if you would like to donate, the link is down the bottom there with our banner. And, if you'd like to hit us up with a couple of dollars, please do. Just click the gift. It's not gift. There's a goods and services checkbox. If you uncheck that, then PayPal doesn't take any fees out. So anyway, let's have another video. I think it's about time. And I know there's a certain young someone in my lounge room that's probably hanging out to see this next video, because this one is myself and my very, very talented daughter, Brooke Ratcliffe, who is singing on this one. So shout out to Matt Neal for helping make this one happen. We filmed this with him, so massive thank you. And so anyway, we've put a little track together, and we hope you like it. This one's nice and upbeat and a bit fun, so enjoy. Brooke Ratcliffe, everybody.
Left a good job in the city, working for the man every night and day. And I never lost 1 minute of sleep, and I was worrying about the way that things might have been. You know that big wheel keep on turning,
turning, brown Mary keep on burning.
And we're You know I pumped a lot of tame down in New Orleans, but I never saw the good side of the city until I hitched a ride on the riverboat queen. Big wheel, keep on turning.
There you go, everyone. Brooke Ratcliffe on the vocals. I tell you what, I tremendously miss, I can't even explain how much I miss being able to perform with Brooke. It's one of the greatest joys I think I've ever had as a musician. is to be able to share the stage with my daughter. So thanks for helping facilitate that, Matt, this week and making that happen. Thanks, Brooke, for all your work in getting that to me. And I can't wait till we can get back out there and keep doing that and keep doing gigs again, because I sure as hell miss it. All right, so we are getting very close. I've got two more videos. We've only got about 25 minutes, so I think I'll probably end up playing another song myself, and then we'll head over to the Corona House Band for this week's installment. Jade is, I believe, probably dead to the world asleep right now, because she's been crook all week, and she still managed to get this video through to us. So huge thanks to Jade for getting it through. I know it's been a tough week. She doesn't have the Rona, though, everyone. She's clear. There is no Rona going on in the Corona House Band at all. And also, obviously, don't forget that it's Jace Howard's birthday. So if everyone can just get on and just completely hang shit on Jason for being an old bastard right now in the comments, that would just make my day. But, yeah, wish him a happy birthday. We were hoping that we'd have we're working on a track with Jason at the moment, but it wasn't quite ready. So we'll probably have that one with me. It's me, Jason, I think Tim and Brett College are working on that at the moment as well. So we will have that next week. We didn't have it for his birthday, unfortunately. So anyway, I'll grab the guitar. Also, next week I've got, we'll be back again. We've got a bunch of stuff in the pipeline. Hopefully, if Jade's feeling better, we've got another track with Jade. Obviously, the Corona Band will be back as we do. I'm also working on a track with Heath Hodgetts, and my band Super Mega are looking at doing something soon as well. So we've got all this stuff going on. Hopefully, I've sorted the gremlins that were in my computer this week. A shocking week this week. Out of sync and bloody things not working, and just one of those things. All right, this one's by an Aussie band. I haven't done some of these songs. I haven't played for so long. There could be a very good reason for that. keep those comments coming. Just stir the absolute crap out of him. He needs it. But yeah, happy Easter birthdays, man. I'm sorry we couldn't hang out. But we will soon. We'll get there. We're not that far away. Just for so that everyone knows, obviously, Ange is still going through chemo. So regardless of what happens in the world of the coronavirus world, we still have to actually, you know, be careful just from general colds and flus and stuff. So we've been in lockdown a little bit longer, but Ange is coming very close to finishing off her chemo. She's only got a couple of weeks left, which is insane, and then she'll move into a different treatment, some radiation. So we're going to have a stream. Her chemo finishes the day before we do our stream on the Friday. So on that particular Friday in a couple of weeks' time, we're going to have a mammoth party night where we're going to play all the videos as a little bit of a celebration, and we're going to have just a massive concert night at for the stream. Instead of me playing, we'll just literally have video after video of all the videos that people have been sending through. So I'm super keen for that. Should be absolutely awesome. Nice one, friend. I don't think there's enough money in the world for that at the moment. All right, let's do a track. This one is by an Aussie band, and I'll probably mess it up, but hey. Thank you.
hot tease, baby. People tend to freak me out. Watch your lips and work it out. I can hear the words, but I still don't know what it's all about. Won't see me down the disco, mama. The bright lights really hurt my eyes. I'd rather stay and dance with you. The funky music playing on your stereo. Things don't get no better, better than you and me. Ooh, things don't get no better, better than you and me. That's right! I don't go to concerts, baby. The music's always up too loud. Cigarettes and alcohol get off my ass. I always use you in the crowd. You won't see me tribal raving, baby. Cause I won't ever look that good. I'd rather dance in ugly pants in the comfort of the lounge room in suburbia.
Many, many, many memories sitting there listening to that album with Tanky, if you're about Tanky. That song always bring back memories of your place and that album. Anyway, just a huge shout out to everyone that has donated tonight. I'm just going to take my guitar off for a second. And anyone that's just sort of like ongoingly supported what we've been doing, everyone that's given their time, huge thanks to our sponsors this week. So DK Audio sponsored tonight's show. So huge thanks to Dave from DK Audio for that. Also, a huge shout out to Karen from Paragon Bookkeeping and Accounting. If you have any accounting or bookkeeping needs, she is the person to chat to. Absolute legend, knows the stuff, knows Muso stuff very, very well as well. So if you need anyone, get in touch with her. She will sort you out. We've got another sponsor for next week's show. I'm not going to say that just yet. We'll use that for next week's show. But they've jumped on as well. So we do have another one in the cards. We have raised somewhere in the vicinity. We're over the $12,000 mark, which is absolutely insane that we've managed to raise that kind of money in 2 months. I am humbled by everyone's support, right through from people that have been donating to people that have been watching to people that have been sharing. If you can't donate, which reminds me, if you can't donate, hit the share button. Share this around as much as you can. get the word out to other people, let people know, say, come and check it out. Hang with us on a Friday night. It's fun. You've got nothing better to bloody do, so come and join us. I'd like to thank, massive thank you to all the people that have been involved and sent me videos. I think I've got so many videos, I'm probably not even going to get to show everyone's throughout this. But I really do appreciate you taking the time out to shoot them through to me. And, for my Muso friends that have been doing the collabs and stuff with me, thank you for taking the time each week to get those together. Because I know, we've all still got different varying levels of busyness and stuff that we have to try and keep on top of and get done. And, you're giving up your time to put into this and support this cause, which is, it means the world to me. So thank you very much to everyone that's done that. All right, now to shut up for a second and have a break, I'm going to hand you over to the Corona House Band, which if you've seen the show before, you'll realise that that does involve myself, Matt Neal, Jade Howard, who's probably asleep, Jade is singing on it. We've got Heidi Maguire and Tim Gambles on the bass guitar. We've got an Australian classic for you this week. I hope you enjoyed this song. It was heaps of fun to put it together. And I'll try and sort of, I'm going to make out that it was really easy. because nothing went wrong this week. No computer problems, no sick people, no... drama at all. It was easy, simple. We just got it done without a worry in the world. Anyway, ladies and gentlemen, drum roll. I don't have a drum. I can't do a drum roll. But anyway, ladies and gentlemen, the Corona House Band, please enjoy.
You know that I plan to win this time.
Corona House Band, everyone. Can I just say, bloody Jade. She's sick and she still sings like that. It's just ridiculous. So, insane. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed that. That was awesome to have a crack at such an absolute Aussie icons track. And I've always loved that track. And the Corona Band's just been the most self-indulgent little project. We literally every week have just picked songs that we've always wanted to play forever and gone, bugger it, let's just do it, because we can. And there's nothing you can do about it because you can't even walk out. You're stuck. So, yeah, we absolutely have loved doing this stuff. And I know the comment was made the other day, which was, goddamn, we're going to have one hell of a gig. We definitely need to do the Corona Band live at some point when things go back to normal. So please, you know, if you can't donate, jump on, share this post, get it out there to as many people and many friends as you can. If you can donate, the link's down the bottom, paypal.me/TasEntBookings, and that will get you straight to my PayPal account. I'm then taking those funds and delivering those funds directly to musicians that have been hit hard. I reckon we've got in touch. We've got funds to around 30 or 40 people so far. We've raised over 12 grand in the 8 weeks that we're doing it. Obviously, some people will go okay soon when the government starts to kick in and give some help. Some people are getting job seeker. Some people are still waiting, like I am, for JobKeeper. And but there are quite a few people out there that have just completely fallen through the cracks and have absolutely no assistance whatsoever. And I've been chatting to them and getting some funds to those people as well. So all this money, just be rest assured that every cent that we get from this at the end of the day is going to go straight into the pocket of someone that actually needs it and will help them get by and do what they need to do. And we're doing that all over Tassie. We've got people in Hobart. We've got people in Devonport, Burnie. We've been getting in touch with just everyone we can. If you know someone that's struggling in the Muso scene at all, or, you know, and I extend that to people that, you know, like Dave's group that have roadies and people that do, gigs for us and help put shows together and stuff. So I extend that help to them as well if they're struggling. Get in touch with me. Let me know. You know, we're not giving out people's names. We're not, you know, we're keeping it all, you know, above board. We're doing it very, very privately. No one has to know you've been given anything from this. And but just get in touch. You know, don't let your pride get in the way of asking for some help. We've got it here. We want to offer it. And so just if you are struggling, please get in touch. Let me know, and we'll sort you out. Anyway, just one more shout out to our sponsors for this week. So DK Audio, Dave from DK Audio has sponsored tonight's show. So thanks, Dave, for doing that. I appreciate it, mate. Love your work. Love working with you. Look forward to the times when we can get back and start doing that stuff again, because, man, we've had some fun gigs over the years. And you've always been an absolute pleasure to work with, so hit Dave up. If you need anything audio-wise down the track, you've got events or anything you want to talk to, Dave's the man to have a chat to. Also, we have Karen, who has literally been involved from day dot. Karen runs Paragon, which is an accounting firm. They do accounting and bookkeeping. So not only do they do accounting, they do bookkeeping. So if you've got a business and you need someone to keep your books, they can sort that out. And it's at, a bookkeeping price. It's not an accounting rate, which a lot of accountants do. They'll charge you accounting rates to do bookkeeping, whereas Karen's group don't. So anyway, jump onto that. If you need any advice, they are absolutely awesome. Karen will sort you out. So huge thanks to our sponsors. We'll be back again next Friday night. And we've got another show in store for you. The Corona Band will be back again. We've got some other appearances from other musos yet again. I'm going to be doing some stuff again. I'll post a link to all our YouTube clips straight after this. So the Corona Band and my cover and Brooke's cover and that, we'll put all those up on YouTube. If you'd like to check out my YouTube channel, just search my name, Lee Ratcliffe, on YouTube, and you'll find me. And hit me up, link, subscribe, like the bell button, I don't even know what I'm saying, but do all that stuff that you're supposed to do with YouTube if you'd like. And keep in touch, and you can see all our videos there. I also post the episode up there afterwards as well. So all the previous episodes are all on my YouTube channel if you want to go back and see them. It's a little bit easier to find on YouTube than it is on Facebook, because you've got to scroll through thousands of people that have shared it on my page. So YouTube's there if you'd like it. And, you can check that out. Please feel free to hit up Scotty Target and have a look at Roboticus. We spoke to him earlier on the show. He's got a new track that just dropped today, and you should definitely check it out. It sounds absolutely awesome, and it's a local act and obviously a local singer as well, so check that out. And thanks to everyone else that's been involved. Happy birthday again, Jace Man. Hope you've had a great day, and I look forward to catching up with you soon. So what are we going to end with? The last thing I'm going to do is I'm going to hand you over to Brett College. Brett is a good friend of ours. We've been doing a few videos with Brett, and he has put this one together. What he has the tendency of doing is he takes a song that every musician doesn't really like, just on the quiet, and puts his own spin on it and sort of does his own version. So the last song for tonight will be Brett. Hope you enjoy. After that, I'm going to sign off. So catch you later, everyone. I'll see you next week on Friday. I do my updates every Wednesday. So if you're around, I'm stuffed up this week. I had a gazillion missed calls going, missed messages and stuff saying, where was your update? Did I miss it? Did I miss your update? I was like, I missed it. So I was so busy, I completely forgot about my own update. So anyway, but Wednesday night is normally when we do our update, so stay tuned for that. So we'll do next week's show. The week after that is going to be a very special week for us in my household, and we're going to have a massive concert version on that particular night. So it'll be a bit different from this. It's going to be all the videos that every single video that we've played so far on the stream. We're just going to have back to back video, song after song after song after song. Stay tuned for that. That's in a fortnight from now. So next week's a normal show. One after that's going to be the big concert. So anyway, I will see you all next Wednesday if I don't forget again. So, my usual spiel, please be nice. Don't be a douchebag. It's pretty simple. If you can stay home, stay home. Do that, Be safe. Don't be a dick. See you later. Brett College, everyone. Hope you enjoy.
I'm gonna know I'm gonna dream about that time when I'm with you.